Bubba Lubba Dub Dub motherfuckers. What's going on, everyone? It is I, everyone's favorite jack of all trades with a foul mouth, Commodore Irvin. And thank you again for tuning in to another special, incredible movie review. I ain't done one of these in a while, and it's going to be a fucking good one. And before I begin, I want to give a big shout to all of you. All my fans, all my subscribers, and all my viewers. Thank you for fucking watching. The reason why I do this shit is for you guys. Now, as you guys can see, we've got Ghostbuster stuff. I've got my 125th scale Ecto-1. I haven't built it yet, but I'm going to probably pretty soon. And I've got my Ghostbusters collection, you know, 1 and 2. And I've got my commemorative Ghostbusters pin and my hat. And the movie I'm going to review to you guys is the new Ghostbusters Afterlife. Yes, the new Ghostbusters movie. The most highly anticipated movie probably of the whole entire fucking year. And I went and saw it opening weekend. I didn't see it on opening night. That would have been the 19th. I saw it on the 20th, which was Saturday, the day after. And oh my god, it was absolutely fucking amazing. So, stay tuned as I tell you guys about the movie and tell you guys my thoughts and responses to the film. And by the way, if you don't want any spoilers, fucking turn the video off now, because there's going to be plenty of fucking spoilers and other good shit. So anyway, the setting of the movie takes place with a truck running away from a massive hill, like a big massive mountain with a bunch of eerie shit going on. And it's some kind of a spirit chasing after a guy in a truck. Well, it turned out the guy in the truck was none other than Egon Spengler. And he was trying to stop Armageddon. And I'll explain why. But anyway, gets back to his house, the farmhouse that he had bought, and has a ghost trap hidden. And this other spirit finds him and kills him. Sadly, he dies. Anyway, his daughter, his daughter and his two grandchildren, one played by Finn Wolfhard, and the other one is played by, I can't forget her name, I can't remember, I forget what her name is now, damn it. I should have wrote this shit down, but anyway, they go out to Oklahoma where he had his dwellings, and they were supposed to be there for a certain bit of time. But then the kids start discovering more about what really was going on at his house and what was being put forth. And the girl, her name is Phoebe. McKenna Grayson, that's who plays as her, McKenna Grayson, discovers more to her grandfather than what she knew, and she discovers that he is indeed the great Egon Spengler. So that makes sense, because she's nerdy and super smart, and he's nerdy and super smart, so I guess it skipped a generation. But anyway, and they find Ecto-1. That's a fucking awesome scene when they find Ecto-1 in the barn. Sad though, I mean, it's sad that the car was in such pitiful fucking shape, but the car is still there. And of course, Finn Wolfhard's character, you know, fiddles around with the car and gets Ecto-1 running again. And one of the first things that they actually do is they catch a ghost. They catch a ghost called Muncher. Son of a bitch is kind of like Slimer, but it fucking eats everything. It don't just eat food, it eats everything. And with the help of a friend that Phoebe made named Podcast, they catch this damn ghost. But really weird shit's happening. And we cue in with the teacher that's in the film, Gary Gruberson, which is played by the amazing Paul Rudd. And then we actually find out more that the mine and the town and stuff are all interconnected with the events that happened in the original Ghostbusters. You guys remember the creepy apartment building with the lithium beams and shit? All that metal and shit was mined out of that mountain. And Ivo Shandor was the one. Yeah, Ivo Shandor and his ugly ass does appear in the movie, but I'll explain here in a little bit. Anyway, he built a fucking worshipping chamber for Gozer in the fucking mountain. And the only way to release Gozer, if you guys remember, is to unite the Gatekeeper and the Keymaster. Well, the Terror Dogs are the Keymaster and the Gatekeeper possess the mother of the kids and the teacher. Yeah. Pretty reminiscent of the fucking first movie. And of course all hell fucking breaks loose. Yeah, Gozer gets released. And of course, Ivo Shandor, which you see when you see him in his sarcophagus laying nearby, come back to life and expresses the fact that he built the entire thing for Gozer and wants to ruin power with Gozer. Gozer fucking just grabs him from the top of his fucking head and rips his ass in two. I'm thinking, wow. This dude was a fucking fanboy and you fucking ripped your biggest fan in two. You really don't give a shit. But it gets really nasty really fast as the kids fight Gozer. But they're not alone. It turns out, early in the movie, Phoebe calls Ray and tries to tell Ray, you know, what's going on, but explains to him right before she was hung up that she was Egon's granddaughter, and somehow, you know, Ray got the boys back together, and so Ray and Peter and, you know, Winston, they all come in cavalry, and all of them fight fucking Gozer. It's absolutely fucking awesome. Fucking awesome. And of course, the whole entire farmhouse was a trap. So they fucking powered the trap up. Finn Wolfhard's character fucking takes his pack, fucking shoots the silo powering thing, get the damn trap going, and fucking trap Gozer and the rest of the damn demons in these fucking massive trap, and it's done. They're done, son. It's all over with. Fucking Armageddon has been stopped. Thanks to the OGs and the newcomers. Absolutely great movie. And during that final boss battle, you actually see the spirit of Egon fighting alongside with the Ghostbusters, you know, helping guide Phoebe as she's, you know, shooting her proton stream at Gozer the Gozerian. And after everything's calmed down, such a beautiful scene, you know, just, I cried, I really fucking cried. It was so emotional, but it was so beautiful. And then at the end of the movie, you see it said for Harold, you know, it was a tribute to Harold Ramis. And such a lovely movie. But the scene that really was funny, though, was when Winston saw Ecto-1, he's like, oh no, what did they do to you, baby? Don't worry, I'll get you home. I'll get you all fixed up and you'll be looking like new in no time. And of course you do see Ecto-1 drive over the Verrazano Narrows Bridge all pristine looking as she's going into Manhattan. And it's absolutely fucking awesome. And of course the movie ends and there's a little bit of a fun scene with Sigourney Weaver and, you know, and Bill Murray where she is reverse of what Bill was during the beginning of Ghostbusters where he was doing the cards or whatever, shocking the guy or whatever. Sigourney Weaver was doing the same thing, shocking Bill, and that's funny as fuck. Absolutely amazing fucking movie. The director of the movie, Jason Reitman, is the son of the man who was the director of the first two movies, Ivan Reitman. So, it was done right. Beautiful movie. Absolutely fucking loved it. Hands down, the best Ghostbusters movie, and it absolutely takes its place with the OGs. It is absolutely fucking amazing. I loved it. I was riveted the whole time I fucking watched it. Now, unlike a certain other movie, Ghostbusters Answer the Call, which was an SJW, woke as fuck, feminazi piece of shit, Ghostbusters Afterlife is absolutely fucking amazing. I loved it. If you love Ghostbusters, you will fucking love Ghostbusters Afterlife. Go fucking watch it. And if you're lucky enough, go watch it in theaters. And by the way, one more thing. AMC is selling these fucking popcorn containers that look like the Ecto-1 from the movie. And they're like $35. And I wish I had the fucking money to buy one. I would have bought one. Because, like I said, I'm a fucking Ghostbusters fanatic. I love Ghostbusters shit. And I could have had it alongside Ecto-1A, but oh well. Yeah, well, it's not in the fucking cards, but, you know, who knows? If you have the money, fucking buy one popcorn container. They're fucking awesome. So there you have it. That is my review of Ghostbusters Afterlife. It is absolutely, it's a 2-thumbs-up film. Fucking 8+. It is the perfect tribute to the original films, and it's done so fucking exquisitely. It is a true masterpiece. And if you have any questions or comments, leave them in the fucking comment section below, and I'll get back with you. If you're new to the channel, fucking hit that subscribe button, hit that damn notification bell. Never miss a video from the Commodore again. Till next time, it's Commodore. It's had smooth seas and clear skies. Have a sailing with all of you. And, you know. And if you're in need of chasing out some spooks, who are you going to call? Ghostbusters. I'll see you along. See ya.